our last lecture. So file, open image. This is lecture number 10. Okay, so first of all, how to create a color grid, and second is from new to old. Last time we have discussed with aqueous colorage how from old to new you can make, and today we will discuss how from a new picture you can convert it into old picture, and last is creating multicolors. So for example, this is our image. For this we will create multiple you can say a grid lines. File, new. So here width 1000 pixel and height 1000 pixel, resolution 96. Okay, after that we will draw the lines, grid lines. Okay, right now look, there is no horizontal and vertical ruler, it's not visible from keyboard. If you press control R, so look, this ruler is now visible. Clear? Or if it is not visible, you can go here in view, and this one, view, ruler. So horizontal and vertical ruler will be visible. After that we will draw the lines. Okay, from just click on the ruler and drag it down. Okay, and in this way we will draw the lines, horizontal and vertical lines. Clear? After that go on the vertical ruler and click on this one and drag, draw a line. Clear? After that we will take row marquee tool or column marquee tool to select these grids, and we will fill the color. So this one, single row marquee tool, click this one and click on these lines, then press shift key, shift, and click on the other lines to add these. Pressing shift key and click on these lines. Shift, simple shift, and click on these lines. Okay, after that take the vertical, this one, single column marquee tool, and click on this, and with pressing shift clear. After that here create a new layer, and layer property give a name for this grid. Clear? When you give a name to a layer, that will be easy for us, that this is our that grid layer. After that go to the edit image, fill with black color. Okay, so automatically these lines are filled. Now it's not visible when we press here, go here, view, and uncheck guides and control D. Uncheck the guide, that lines, and control D, deselected. So these lines are visible now. Clear? We have given which color? Black color. So you can give any color. Clear? So after that, go to this image. This one image. And first of all, on this layer image, first of all, click on background. Click on background. Then go to this image and with the move tool. Click on move tool and drag it, place on this. After that, you can close this image. There is no need of this image. Now look here, a layer 1 is created. One is grid layer, one is your layer 1. After that, click on this and control T, transform it. Clear? Okay. So in this way, okay, just a minute. Click and drag this one. Apply. Okay. So now we have inserted an image on this background layer and layer 1 is created. After that, click on the grid layer. After that, take magic wand tool and click on these and press shift with this. Shift click. After this selection, go to edit menu and fill. First of all, here make a new layer. On this layer apply the color. Go to edit and fill with white color. This one, okay. Clear? So surrounding or the side color that was blue color, it is removed with white color. Control D, deselect this one. After that, look, this is your grid layer. You can move it, place on the top. After that, click on the grid layer. Clear? And draw some selection. Take again this wand tool and click on shift. Like this. You have selected these 8 boxes. After that, click on the layer, go to hue saturation, click on colorize, and here if you give 70, click. So that selected boxes are colored with red color. Clear? After that, again go to the grid layer with that tool, when tool, click on this and select some other boxes like this. Okay, and after that again click on the layer number 1, this one, and use saturation, colorize, and here if you make it 0 and click okay, so look, a light color is applied here, this one. After that, go to the layer, grid layer, this one. With the same tool, select some other boxes. Clear? And click on this, use saturation, colorize. If you change the color, light, now apply. So look, these colors are applied. So in this way you can apply multiple colors. It's up to you. Select the different boxes with the magic wand tool and apply the saturation. One by one you can apply the saturation on different boxes. It's up to you that how you are arranging this. After that, click on the grid layer and move it on the top. Okay. So I have created 3 hue saturation layer, 1, 2, 3. And these layers you can also apply some other properties like colors, green or blending modes, okay? So first of all, go here on the grid layer, click on this lock. First of all, lock this layer. After that, go to the edit menu, fill with white color. So surrounding is that layer which is selected in the grid, that is applied a white color. After that, if you go here in the strokes, this one, click on the strokes and select a color. Right now red color is selected. If you select white color and okay, after that size, if you give one size and look here, if you increase the size, so grid will be like this, okay? So it's up to you how much widths you give. I have given 3, okay? So after that, if you click on this layer, use saturation, apply here 2, okay? Now look, after that, if you click on any layer, this one, use saturation and apply which, for example, screen. So that will be applied. Look on here, apply screen mode is applied. For example, on this layer, if you apply color mode, so look, color is applied. So it will be different properties you can apply on each layer which you have selected. So in this way, you can make a color grid. So this is your color grid. Save this one. File, save as on your desktop with JPG. Save this one. Okay. This one. Okay. So we have created this color grid. Okay. After that, yes. Okay. Lecture number 10, B part. File, open an image. Okay, now new to old picture. Okay, this one. Control H. If you don't need ruler, Control R. Okay, so after that, this is a new picture, so from this we want to create an old picture. So first of all, here, click on the use saturation, colorize, and here you amount give 40, apply it. So look, first of all, we have applied on this layer a use saturation. After that, create a layer number 1. Press Control Shift E, Alt Control Shift and E. So what happened? So these two layers are merged into layer number 1. Clear? Layer, this one background layer and this saturation layer is merged into layer number 1. What I have done? Created a new layer. From this I can just click on the create new layer. This one, new layer is created, layer number 1. And on this I have applied Alt Control Shift and E. E mean control, merge these two layers. So down two layers are merged into layer number 1. Clear? After that, on the layer number 1, go to the filter and apply the blur and Gaussian blur. And its amount is too much, so give here 4 pixels. Okay? After that, so it's not visible, clear? So go here in the blending mode, apply overlay. And it's decrease the opacity, like this one, 50 or less than 50. Clear? Look here, click on the layer number 1, go to the filter and apply the blur and Gaussian blur, and its amount 4 pixels. After that, go here in the layer mode, so apply the overlay. Clear? After that, create a new layer. Click here, new layer. Fill this with a black color. You can go in the edit menu, or a shortcut is Control Alt Backspace. Alt Backspace, the 4 color is applied here. After that, take a elliptical marquee tool and draw a selection. Like this. Look, here I have created layer 2 and applied a color, black color. After that, with the elliptical marquee tool, I have selected this a circular area, and Alt, press Alt key and click on the vector mask, this mask, a small area. A vector mask will be added with this layer. Alt, vector mask. So look, vector mask is applied. After that, look, this surrounding is black, so it's very rich, so you can decrease the opacity. No, one thing more. When you apply this, go to the filter menu and apply the blur, Gaussian blur, and its amount increase 25. Okay. After that, decrease the opacity. Decrease the opacity. Look here. Before this, it was like this, and now borders or the surroundings are dark. So you can make more less opacity, decrease it. Now look here. This was your previous image. Now on the surrounding, it is applied. What we have done, created a layer, layer 2, filled with the black color, and after that, Alt. Click on the vector mask. So vector mask is added, and after go apply the filter, Gaussian blur, and 25%. Okay. After that, create another layer. Click on the layer new. So Alt backspace. Fill with the back color and add noise. Noise we have also discussed last time. Here noise, its amount give 130 or 120 like this. Okay. After that, it's not visible. So what we do, go into the blending mode and apply soft light. So look, it's very, too much dots are there, so decrease the opacity. Click on the opacity and decrease. Look here, it's up to you that how much you need, like this. 20 or 19 or 20, 20 plus, it's okay. After that, create another layer. So layer 4 is created, apply Alt backspace, the same color, a background black color applied, and after that, go to the filter menu, and here we have texture, clear? In texture, we will apply the grains, grains will be applied. So what type of grain you need? Vertical grains, horizontal grains, circular grains, which type of grains you need? So here is the option of vertical grains. So look here, if you increase their intensity, look here, vertically it is visible. You can decrease intensity, it's up to you that how much intensity you need, like this. And you can apply the contrast also. If you increase contrast, it will be less visible. If you decrease the contrast, so look, these lines will be applied. So like this, and if you increase intensity, 54, and decrease the contrast like this, and okay. Now look here, layer number 4. On layer number 4, we have applied the texture filter, and after that, it's not visible. Go to the layer mode and apply which one? Screen mode. Clear? And after that, you can decrease the opacity. Look, so in this way, you can apply, you can make a from a new picture to old picture. Now look here, if you want to make, you want to give a color to it, so go to this layer and decrease the opacity. Here, the saturation layer which we have created at the start. So if you decrease the opacity, so color is applied like this. Clear? So in this way you can make a from new to old picture. And last time we have discussed from old to new picture with the help of Colorage software, Aquis Colorage. So this was lecture number 2. Save this one on desktop with lecture 10 B part with JPG. Clear? Go to the file, open. Recording is start. So here lecture number 10. This is your C part to create the multiple colors. Okay. First of all, go to the view menu. Here, new guide. Click on new guide and apply the percentage. Vertical or horizontal? Lines like this, vertical or horizontal or vertical lines you want to apply on this. So right now I have clicked on vertical, and if I give 25%, so on the 25% of the image I draw, vertical line will be applied. So click OK. So one line is drawn at 25. Again go to the view menu and apply a new guide. And this, if I give the 50%, apply. So 25 plus added, 50%, there are another line is drawn. After that, go to the view menu and apply new guide, and if I give 75%, okay? So four columns are created there. Now, on each column, you can give a separate color and apply the layer properties. So, rectangular marquee tool and select this one. Okay, within this area, select this one and go to the hue saturation, colorize, and like this. After that, again, select this layer and go to saturation layer, colorize it. Okay, increase it, okay, apply this one. Again, select the third layer, third column, go to saturation and colorize. Okay. And draw the last layer here, apply the saturation. Okay, so in this way you have applied different colors. Go to the view menu and clear all guides. Okay. So select any one of this layer. Now look here, four layers are created. 1, 2, 3, 4 different columns we have selected. So four layers are created. On any one of them, you can select it and go to strokes. For example, if you apply the black strokes on the surrounding, okay. So look, a vertical black line is drawn. If you decrease its size 1, okay. Now look. A single line is applied. Further properties you can also apply. If you go here in the inner glow, shadow, outer glow, different properties are there. If you apply one property, so that will be applied on this layer. Now you can copy this property to the other layers. The same thing you can apply on other layers. How? Click this layer, go to the layer option. And here is a layer property, layer style. Copy layer style, okay, and click on the second layer, this one, and go to layer option, layer style, and click here, paste style. So same thing is applied here, look, on the second layer. Whatever the properties you have applied on one layer, you can apply on all other layers. Let's suppose on the third layer, this one, here I want to apply the same properties, so go to the layer option, layer style, paste that one. Look, this line, and in the last layer, here, if you applied it, layer style and paste the style. So in this way, you can apply the layer property from one layer to another layer. And you can create a multicolor image. So this was your lecture number 10, C part.